Thank you for your patience. And also thank you for your presence here this afternoon. My name is Richard Doyens, and I am one of the pastors here at Christ Church of the Valley. And on behalf of the entire Adame family, Jesus, Alex, Sadie, Alexis, Josh, and all of the extended family, I want to welcome you to this celebration of life and memorial service for Alma Rosa Adame. Thank you again for being here. On May 28th, Alma departed this world to be with our Jesus. So it is that we are gathered here out of love for Alma and respect for the family to remember, reflect, and to celebrate the life Alma shared with us. And although her life was cut short, Alma leaves a deep impression on those she left behind. We mourn the briefness of her journey, her absence from us here today, and to seek comfort from family, friends, and God. Together, we will focus on three very important things in our brief time together. First, we are here to remember, honor, and celebrate Alma's life. We will do this through reflection, music, shared memories, and a message of hope. Second, this is our chance to reinforce our ties to one another. Most importantly, our love and support for her family and friendship with Alma. Thirdly, we must reevaluate and refocus our own lives and how we will carry on the memory of Alma, how we will live our lives to the fullest and focus ever more intently on our life's purpose and the priorities of faith, family, and friends. As we were meeting earlier this week to talk about the celebration of life with the immediate family, I shared part of this with them. And I want to read the entire psalm to you here this afternoon. It's Psalm 139. And it says, O Lord, you have examined my heart and know everything about me. You know when I sit down or stand up. You know my thoughts even when I am far away. You know everything I do. You know what I'm going to say even before I say it, Lord. You go before me and you follow me. You place your hand of blessing on my head. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, too great for me to understand. I can never escape from your spirit. I can never get away from your presence. If I go up to heaven, you are there. If I go down to the grave, you are also there. If I ride the wings of the morning, if I dwell by the farthest oceans, even there your hand will guide me and your strength will support me. I could ask the darkness to hide me and the light around me to become night. But even in the darkness, I cannot hide from you. To you the night shines as bright as the day. Darkness and light are the same to you. You made all the delicate inner parts of my body and knit me together in my mother's womb. Thank you for making me so wonderfully complex. Your workmanship is marvelous. How well I know it. You watched as I was being formed in utter seclusion, as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. You saw me before I was ever born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. How precious are your thoughts about me, O God. They cannot be numbered. I can't even count them because they outnumber the sands of the sea. I like to read that last part. You watched Alma as she was being formed in utter seclusion. As Alma was woven together in the dark of her mother's womb, you saw Alma before she was even conceived. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. How precious are your thoughts about Alma, O God. They cannot be numbered. I can't even count them as they outnumber the sands of the sea. Isn't that an awesome thought? It's a lot of precious thoughts. Psalm 139 tells us that life is never an accident. Every life is precious, and every life is a gift from God, regardless of how long or short that life may be. Would you pray with me? Our Father in heaven, we are gathered to celebrate a very special life created by you and given to us. Thank you so much for Alma. Thank you for the many wonderful reflections and memories that we are especially mindful of today. Thank you for the special way she imprinted her personality and her life on us. Bless our time together as we remember and treasure her as you do. Surround each person here according to their special and unique needs. Allow us the joy of laughter and comfort through our tears of mourning. Draw us closer together as family and friends. Thank you for your comforting and compassionate presence available to all to be drawn upon in this special time. In Jesus' name, amen. At this time, I'd like to introduce Alexis Olivas, one of Alma's daughters. It's okay. It's not that long a walk.
I'm pretty short. I don't know how this is going to work. Okay. So I wrote this, and I have to read it because I don't want to forget anything. So, we are here today to celebrate the life of my mother, Alma Adame, and to remember how much she meant to us. I'm Alexis, Alma's youngest daughter. She always called me her miracle baby. Alma was born March 4th, 1955 in La Feria, Texas. Her parents were Beatrice and Jose Becerra. Our mother was the fourth born of 18 children. Yes, 18 children. She was the oldest daughter and helped her mother raise her siblings in El Mirage, Arizona. She didn't have an easy life, but through all of her obstacles, she always conquered anything that came her way, which helped make her a strong woman. My mother has four children, Alex, Sadie, Josh, and I. Our mother did not finish high school, but she was self-educated. Throughout her lifetime, she read books and articles to educate herself. It was a rare occasion if she didn't read the daily newspaper. Every time I offered to buy things she needed, she always requested her reading material. She taught our father, Jesus, how to speak and read English over 38 years ago. My parents were best friends. They did not always see eye to eye, but they always supported and took care of each other. My mom always expressed to me that regardless if they were together or not, she would always help and love him since he is our father. Thank you, Dad, for being selfless and taking care of Mom these past few years. I know it was not easy, but you both did it for your family. She was the pillar of our family. She always knew how to fix everything. And I mean everything. If my toilet wasn't working, like, she knew how to fix it. I didn't have to call a plumber. She always knew. Or she had the answer on how to do things. Our mother had a heart of gold and loved unconditionally. She didn't judge anyone and always wanted to help someone, even if it meant giving her last dollar. Our mother did everything possible for my siblings and I, even if it caused her pain or stress. She never complained. Okay, she complained. But she still did it. She was a tough cookie. No one could tell her what to do. If she didn't like something, she wasn't afraid to tell you so. Our mother was the life of the party. She loved a good time. Her smile and laugh were infectious, and she just loved to entertain. She would even find the humor during her days of dialysis. She hated needles, and being sick took a toll on her body, but she had to make sure that she wore fuzzy, funny pajama pants or a crazy hat to make someone else smile. She made friends wherever she went and could start a conversation with anyone. Our mother taught us so many things about life and love throughout our whole lives. I would keep you here for hours, with all the great things I can say about her. She did always tell us, do what makes you happy. Take care of yourselves and your families. She has 5 granddaughters, Jasmine, Jacinta, Bronte, Charlie, and Lily, and 1 grandson, EJ. He's a little terror, but he's over there somewhere. And her Ellis grandchildren. She loved them all so much. My mother requested a fun party for her celebration of life. She would not want anyone to be sad or crying. I can hear her voice. Why are you crying? You're still crying? Please cherish the memories you have of her, and let's keep her in our hearts and thoughts today and always. And thank you all for being here with us. It means the world to my family and I. Thank you.
At this time, Alex, her son, he's walking farther.
Thank you everyone for being here, friends and family. One fond memory that I have, many, many years ago. I found this number that my wife should not have had on her. And it said the number La Z Boy. And I'm thinking to myself, you know, when did she have time to pick up this number from this guy? And then I'm thinking, you know, who's this guy? And just my world fell apart. My heart broke in two. Just everything changed in an instant. And I'm still thinking, it's like, who is this guy? La Z Boy. What kind of guy is this that has this kind of name? I'm thinking to myself, this is insane. This is crazy. I took a better part of the day just breaking myself down and building myself back up, crying, couldn't put the tears back, definitely trying to figure out, not being able to figure out, where did she meet this guy? When did she have the time? I prayed, and where did I go wrong? Did I push her away to this guy's arms to get this number, to find this new companion? I went insane several times over that day. And I just remember it coming on over me, just, you know what, call mom. Talk to mom. Mom knows. You know she knows. Just call mom. Called mom, spent about an hour on the phone. A couple of stiff drinks along the way on the phone. And in the end, she gave me, you know, just the solid, sound advice that she would give any family member, or any friend, or any stranger on the street. And that advice was the best advice. I had to find out who this individual was. This guy that took everything away from me. That I was not going to be satisfied until I spoke man to man to this man. Okay, mom. You know what? I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to take your advice. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to dial the number and just, if anything, find out where I went wrong. Here I am picking up the phone, dialing the number. Phone's ringing. Sure enough, someone picked up. And I could feel it. My world is about to change. I'm gonna get a divorce. All this that we built up is just gone out the window. And I'm waiting, anticipating. Here comes the guy on the phone. And then here it is. Lights, camera, action. Thank you for calling Lazy Boy Furniture. How may I help you? These are the jokes, people.
Thank you.
And that's a fond memory that I have of my mom. Thank you once again for coming. And once again, Mom wouldn't want you to be down and out. Enjoy life. You have it here. It's in front of you. Use it to your best graces. Once again, thank you.
To read some thoughts from Alma's brother, Julio Becerra. He says, "My sister Alma, when I think of Alma, her smile, laughter, and love for life come to my mind first. Alma had a very sweet and a big heart for everyone. Alma loved roses, carnations, and music." You wouldn't have known that by all the flowers down here, would you? Alma made the best tortillas in the world. She knew how much I loved them, and she always had a huge stack of them ready for me when we visited. Alma and I always kept in touch, even when we were thousands of miles apart. Especially over the last few years, we would call each other every other week. She talked about how proud she was of her children, Alex, Sadie, Alexis, and Josh. She talked about her love for her grandchildren, and we also talked about our dogs. During our long conversations, she would laugh a lot, and sometimes I hardly got to say anything, but that was okay. Growing up with Alma as my first little sister was so special. She was so loving to all of our little brothers and sisters. Definitely a little mom. And a special occasion was on March 10th, 2017, we took Alma to a very funny mystery dinner event over in Scottsdale. I don't know how many of you have ever gotten to go to one of those, but they're quite a hoot. She loved it, and we loved watching her make everyone at our table laugh. She even had the characters laughing at her comments. It was a very special time for us. I will always be thankful for the special things about Alma and for her being my little sister. Love you, sis. Julio.
Enjoy yourself. Come on and move. Let the madness in the music.
for the times that you've given me. The memories are all in my mind. And now that we've come to the end of our rainbow, there's something I must say out loud. You once, twice, three times later, and I love you. Yes, you once, twice, three times later. The moments I cherish with every beat of my heart. To touch you, to hold you, to feel you, to need you. There's nothing to keep us apart.
I always love looking at the pictures. I know all of you guys do too. And as you looked at those, it brought back a lot of memories, a lot of things to think about, of times that you spent with Alma, and special things that she did, special things that she said. You know, I have a little story to share with you. The family came in and we were talking, and Lupe was with me and the family and the girls and Jesus. And the more we talked, the more stories we told, the more we laughed. And when we got all done, there was some tears involved, but there was a ton of laughter. And I haven't told you guys this yet, but after we got all done, because we were in one of the other buildings here on campus, and there was a number of the other pastors were there, and they said, "Wasn't that about a funeral?" And you guys were all laughing. And we said, you know what, we had such a great time talking about Alma and a bunch of the things that she did and said. And we had a great time celebrating her then that day. And so before we even got to today. So you have heard it said that some people come into our lives and quickly go. Others stay for a while and leave footprints on our hearts that we can never erase, and we are never the same. Alma was such a woman. I've been told that Alma was a hard worker, that she helped so many other people, was dedicated, was a strong woman, and a great wife. Who really is great? What is the definition of greatness? Jesus said, "He that is greatest among you is servant of all." By God's standard, Alma was great because she had a servant's heart. Someone wrote, "Every person's life makes some type of impression where they travel. But who makes the most enduring and indelible mark on history has served humanity with their life and talents." In the Bible, book of Hebrews, it says, "Though being dead, yet they speak. You cannot bury influence." Influence is the total effect of one's life upon another. Because you see, Alma's life doesn't end here, not by a long shot. Her life cannot be contained. In a place we call eternity, someone will most definitely say, "Alma, you made a difference in my life." And the ripple effect of her life will continue moving forward as many of you, you adults, her children, and even her grandchildren in the years to come will be indebted to a woman because of the difference, the ripple effect she made in the life she was able to touch with all of you. We realize that this is not the end because memory is one gift of God that death can never destroy. So from the moment we heard about Alma's passing until now, some of those days have been difficult. It's been a roller coaster of emotion, and people have tried to comfort. Questions swirl in our minds, and sometimes we're not sure how to think or act. Today especially is hard, for we come to celebrate a life that still seemed to have so much more to give, a life cut short. It's not uncommon for people to ask why. Others of you may have thought, why would God have allowed this to happen? We want to know why certain things happen the way they do. However, it seems that most of the time our whys are left unanswered. And I'm certainly not going to stand here this afternoon and tell you that I know God's purpose in Alma's death. Today, many of us gathered here have questions and few answers. But let me tell you what we do know. We are heartsick and brokenhearted over Alma's death. But through it all, we must believe that God is a loving God who deeply cares for us and desires a personal relationship with all of us, with each one of you. Nothing we can say and nothing we can do can take away the pain of losing Alma, but we can cry with hope because we know our goodbye is not the end. And we can grieve with hope because we believe that there's a place where we'll see Alma's face again, her beautiful face. The Bible tells us our sorrow is not the sorrow of those who have no hope. It's only normal that we experience sorrow and grief when death removes a loved one from our lives. We have sorrow because of our loss. Death has deprived us from the joys of that one's presence. So the grief that we feel is for ourselves. But our Christian faith tells us that death has separated us from the one we love for a time, but certainly not forever. One day we will go to be with our loved one, and the pain of sorrow and grief will be a thing of the past. Jesus said in the book of John, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. And in my Father's house," it says, "there's many mansions." Think about that. "In my Father's house, there's many mansions. And if it were not so, I would have told you. But I'm going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me so that where I am, there you can be also. I love that promise. You know the way to the place where I am going. Because you see, heaven first and foremost is the presence of God. God's intention from the beginning is to have fellowship with man. And heaven can also be characterized as the removal of all evils. The best way to describe what we can expect to be as true followers of Christ comes from the Lord himself on the cross as he paid for our sin. And as one of the criminals repented and asked Jesus to remember him when he came into his kingdom, Jesus said to him, "Truly I say unto you, today you shall be with me in paradise." To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Alma is in paradise today and in the presence of our Lord and Savior. And if she were here with us in this room today and spoke to us, she would assure us that the prize, no matter how hard or difficult, is worth the race. Because you see, you can never give up. She never did. She never gave up. She fought all the way. She is now part of the great cloud of witnesses that is cheering us on, pleading with us to take heart and to continue to fight the good fight, never losing sight of the goal, heaven, and an eternity with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Alma is there right now experiencing the glory of God and is excited at the thought of uniting with those she loved here on earth. And I know that through Jesus Christ, Alma's life and the things that she taught us will be a much bigger part of our futures than our past. See, the secret to real life is not why or even what, but who. And that who is Jesus Christ. Even through times of suffering and pain, we need to fix our gaze on Jesus. As believers, we must stay focused on our Lord Jesus Christ, for it is only through Christ Jesus that we can enter the kingdom of heaven. John 14:6 says, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." And so what Jesus wants us to understand is that this world is temporary. We're just passing through. He desires to have a relationship with you and has a place prepared for you in heaven to live for all eternity if you choose. Remember, Psalm 139 told us that life is never an accident. Every life is precious and every life is a gift from God, regardless of how long or short that life is. So when any life is over, we grieve. When Alma's life here on earth ended just a short time ago, just a few short days ago, we believe and know that her new life in heaven began, because I believe with all my heart that her last breath here was her first breath there. Today we know that Alma is safe and in the loving and caring presence of our Almighty God. And one day we too will join Alma and live forever with our Father in heaven. If you are a Christ follower, you will see Alma in heaven. We cannot change what has happened, but we must continue to live our lives faithfully for God. Whatever it takes, make sure that you follow Jesus and are going to heaven. You will see Alma there. You can count on it. See, God did not create us to be alone. He created us to have relationships. That's why you're all here. The Bible tells us that we have been created in the image or likeness of God so that we can establish and enjoy a personal relationship with him. And throughout the pages of the Bible, we are reminded over and over again how much God loves and cares for each one of us. That's Psalm 139 said, "His precious thoughts about each of you are more than the sands of the sea." In Romans 8:38 and 39 we read, "And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today or our worries about tomorrow, not even the powers of hell, can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below, indeed nothing, absolutely nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. Because you see, life is uncertain and most definitely fragile. And even the strongest one of us here today will pass from this life into the next. And life for all of us will one day end. And we will be the ones that others remember. Not only is it important how we live our lives, it is vitally important. It's vitally important to prepare for the moment when our own lives end. Because you see, life is all about making choices. Since death is unavoidable, since its time of arrival is uncertain and it's always unwelcomed, we must nevertheless prepare for it. So let me ask you this question. If you were to die today, what would happen to you? If you are uncertain of the answer, if you do not know if you will spend eternity in heaven, I've got not only good news for you, I've got great news for you. I've got good news, great news of hope and grace. Jesus tells us in the Bible in John 3:16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus. And whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life." You see, God's love is total. It reaches every corner of our life experience. It is wide. It covers the breadth of our own experience, and it reaches out to the whole world. Our God is huge. God's love is long. It continues the length of our lives, which is just a breath. It is high. It rises to the heights of our celebration and elation. And then his love is so deep. It reaches to the depth of our discouragement, despair, and even death. You see, we can live a good life, help those around us in need, and even once in a while go to church. But that will not save you. In Romans it says this: righteousness, this cleanliness comes from God through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. There is no difference, for all of us have sinned. We've all screwed up. And we fall short of the glory of God. And the wages of that sin is eternal separation from God, spiritual death, if you will. But the gift of God is the eternal life that can be found through Jesus Christ. The only saving grace is not how good that we have lived, but that which we have from the Lord Jesus Christ, because he is the only way. The God of the Bible is a God of love and mercy. That is why he has done so much to make it possible for all of us to belong to his family forever. But yet God does not force his will or his ways upon us. He gives us free choice and allows us to either choose him or go our own way. If any of you are here today and don't know our Jesus, I'd ask that you consider a life with Christ. I hope that you choose to follow the adventure that God has planned for you and the purpose for which he created you. We also came here today to find support and comfort. And as friends and family, you will find support from each other. I ask that you encourage each other, you help each other, cry together, and I hope you do a lot of laughing together. We need each other to make it through these tough times in our lives. This is also a time for us to let God wrap his loving arms around us. Psalm 147:3 says he heals the brokenhearted and bandages their wounds. See, one of the strangest things about us as human beings is that it's our inability to really consider our friends and family until they're gone. So don't take life for granted. Enjoy every day. Laugh every day. And tell someone that you love them every day. because none of us knows the day or the hour when our earthly life may be over. So enjoy it and make the most of it. Don't take your loved ones for granted. Surround yourselves with people that love you. And let the ones that you love know it. Don't be afraid to say, I love you. Say it often. Say it loud. Say it with words. And say it with actions. And don't take God for granted. God is there for you in the good times and the bad. He is there because he loves you more than you could possibly ever know. Matthew 7:7 says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. Everyone who seeks finds. And to everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Today we have gathered together to remember, reinforce, reevaluate, and refocus. To love deeper and invest more wisely in the real treasures of life. Faith, family, and friends. As we honor Alma's life and mourn her death, we thank God for her. We recommit today to reinforce the ties that hold this family together. We will continue to do so over the days, weeks, and years to come. I ask you to take a few brief minutes to think about your life, even your death, and the legacy you leave behind every day that you live. There's a poem that goes like this. I read of a man who stood to speak at the funeral of a friend. He referred to the dates on her tombstone from the beginning to the end. He noted that first came the date of her birth and spoke of the following date with tears. But he said what mattered most of all was the little dash between those years. For that dash represents all the time that Alma spent alive on earth. And now only those who loved her know what that little line is worth. For it matters not how much we own, the cars, the house, the cash. What matters most is how we live and love and how we spend our dash. So think about this long and hard. Are there things you'd like to change? For you never know how much time is left that can still be rearranged. If we could just slow down enough to consider what's true, real, and always try to understand the way that other people feel, and be less quick to anger and show appreciation more, and love the people in our lives like we've never loved before. If we treat each other with respect and more often wear a smile, remembering that this special dash might only last a little while. So when your eulogy is being read with your life's actions to rehash, would you be proud of the things they'd say about how you spent your dash? Gives you a lot to think about. Alma packed a lot of life into her dash. I'd like to leave you with some closing thoughts as you reflect on Alma Rosa Adame. Here's all the things I know. She was a friend, a sister, a wife, a servant. I think of her as a warrior princess, maybe even a warrior queen. I think that's probably what it was. Faithful, trustworthy, hardworking, dependable. She was a protector. She was an encourager. She was thoughtful, humble, generous. The list could go on and on. She loved others. I heard she was feisty, but I choose to say it that she was real in her relationships. And you better have walked the line. You guys know, see? But what I enjoyed most and caught my immediate attention when others were talking about Alma with us could be summed up in these two words. Her heart. She had a ginormous heart. A woman of faith who was strong, who possess great strength, bold, resilient, nurturing, smart, a firecracker, feisty. If you're older like me, you call that ornery. Accepting, who made herself available to everyone, even to those on the street. Funny, sweet, sincere, faithful, loving, interreflective, available, involved, committed, caring over and above, never expecting anything in return. So many of the qualities and attributes that we all aspire to have. Alma had a ton of those. Loves of her life, her brothers and sisters, her husband, her children, her grandchildren, her familia. One of the things I did like a lot was Jesus and Alma were intentional. Even though they separated for a number of years, but deciding when she got sick to step closer together to get through rather than continuing to step away and moving forward on their own. That was pretty amazing to me. You see, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous, boastful, proud, or rude. It always protects, it always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. It says, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be still. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. But love will last forever. I think of Alma, I think about infectious laughter. When she laughed, it made you want to laugh. And even now, Alma would have wanted that way. Because we get through lots of things with laughter. Her legacy lives on through each one of you, her children and grandchildren, and what she gave and shared with each one of you. With the time that you did have, cherish your moments, which collect rather quickly and are sustained in the beauty of our memories, because those can never be lost to us. And as God was with you in each of those moments throughout your lives, and with your mom, he is with you now in these moments of death and mourning. The kind of love your mom shared with you lives on through you and through each of your kids. Forgetting will become one of your fears as you walk on grief's road, but you will never forget your times with her. Your pain and grief will grow less intense, but your memories and your love for her will continue to grow stronger and stronger. 2 Timothy 4:7 says, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, and I have remained faithful. Alma fought a fierce fight, always with a smile. Alma has finished her race, and Alma remained faithful. Will you bow your heads and close your eyes as we close in prayer? Lord God, sometimes we don't know what to say, and we just simply turn to you. That is the case today. We turn to you who are our strength during this time of death. You are the giver of life in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is the source of eternal life to all who would believe. You also understand death. You are our answer in time of trouble. So we stand together and alongside this precious family to simply say, while we don't know why, we're going to choose to trust you today. Father, you know our grief, the sorrow and disappointment of our loss. Give us peace and comfort. Dry our tears, soothe our pain. How thankful we are that Jesus rose on the third day, never to die again. We cling to this promise, because I live, you shall live also. Thank you, dear Father, for his victory over death and for the grace and love that share his victory with us. Deepen our trust in our Savior and strengthen our resolve to live for him. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. On behalf of the entire family, we'd like to thank you again for taking the time to be here. Your presence was deeply appreciated. Behind you, as you came in and as you now are going to go back outside, there are some memory cards. If you did not get the opportunity to fill one of those out, please take time to do so. Memories are precious, and they can never be lost to us. So take a moment to write a thought, write a verse, a word of encouragement. The family would love to have that. And also as well, there's a whole bunch of food back there. And if you haven't smelled it, I know you guys, some of you guys were looking that way while I was talking, but I didn't say anything about that. But it's back there. But before we partake in all of that, we're going to go outside and have an awesome balloon toss. And we've got a special guy here that is musically talented, and Ethan Newman. And he's going to share an acoustic song with us, Here Comes the Sun. So that will be awesome as we let go of the balloon. But I'm going to dismiss the family first. We're going to go outside, do the balloon release, and then we're all going to come back in and get something to eat. Thank you so much for being here.
Little darling, it seems like years since it's been here. Here comes the sun, doo-doo-doo-doo. Here comes the sun, and I say, it's all right. It's all right.
All right, guys, on the count of three, okay?
Okay.
One, two,
three.
Love your mom. To everybody who came along for the ride for today. Remember, Mom's deal was she'd dance when she had a chance to dance. She'd pop a joke, would like to listen to a joke whenever, if ever you had one. And life is fleeting, and you can't help
getting old, but you can get there gracefully. God bless you, Mom. I'll see you in a minute, all right? Later. Let's start off with the VIP table, if you don't mind. Over this way. Okay. If anybody at this table, Gina, would like to say anything to the camera at all, please speak up.
Or just...
Thank you for being Alex's mom.
Okay. One more time.
Thank you for being Alex's mom. Thank you for being Alex's mom.
Thank you for everything that you have done, for all everything, your opinions, of everything I mentioned to you. Thank you for buying me my first phone.
There we go.
And checking in.
And you remember she was at your wedding. She danced at your wedding.
Everybody on the spot.
I know, right?
That's Alex.
Thank you for dancing at my wedding, and thank you for keeping my husband under your wing.
Wow. Okay, you don't have to. You can say hi.
Hi.
Mom, yes, I was out patrolling the kindergarten yards when I met your son. Thank you so much for bringing him into my life and on this earth. Rest in peace. Love you.
Thank you. Okay. This take.
Oh. And yes, we're friends from work.
Yeah. We used to work with Alexa, so we came to support her and the family.
Just Alma was amazing and raised amazing children.
Wow.
Grateful to meet
our
them.
Our third sister. Okay. All right. See? Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, oh, from both of us. That's my mom. She came to support me because Alexa's one of my best friends.
Wow, there it is. There it is, folks. Thanks for the support.
Hello, I'm Nicole. I just want to say that, I don't even know what to say. Alma, I love you and I will always be thinking about you.
Thank you.
All I'm going to say.
Do the voice.
No, I'm not going to do the voice on the camera. No? I'm just going to say I'm going to miss Alma because she was my kindred spirit. Because between, you know, both of us, if it wasn't me saying something the wrong way, it was her. So I'm glad she said it because I always thought it. So she was awesome and she's going to be really missed.
Ma'am? Yes? No? No? Make sure you get a good... No. Beautiful smiles, though. You got the smiles, Brandon? They got those to offer. Thank you, ladies.
Thank you.
I know Alma's family. We were raised in El Mirage. We used to go to school together. And she had a lovely mom, Beatriz. My mom loved her a lot, and we loved her a lot. And I just remember we loved them a lot. And all her kids, too, and her husband. But they moved to Phoenix, and we didn't see them hardly anymore. But we're here celebrating Alma's life. Everything was, God bless you.
I'm Alma's brother, and I miss her with all my heart. I love her. I'm glad she's in a better place, and I will always miss her. She was the best friend of mine, and she will be missed by me and all my family. I love you, sister.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Gilbert Trevino.
Alma
was my tia, a real close tia to me, and I used to love her when she used to sing songs. Especially to me and my wife in the beginning when I first met my wife. She was singing us these little love songs and it was funny. Love you, dear. You have a good night.
My name is Adrian Trevino. Part of the family, so I say thanks for inviting all of us for this time gathering. Sorry for the losses. As much love and respect for the whole family, my wife, and all things as it was.
Here because I love my sister and I'm going to miss her very much.
I miss my sister very much too, and she'll be always in our memories and be missed with a lot of love from all the family. Thank you so much for letting us here to be with you in this social, very nice evening. Thank you.
A smile for me. There she is. Okay, we're good.
I love you, Sadie and Alexis, and my heart goes out to you, and you'll be in my prayers always. Love you guys.
Sadie, Alexis, Josh, and Pops. I
I love you so much, and I know that Alma will always live in your heart. Thank you so much for such a beautiful celebration.
Wow. We will miss you, Alma, Alexis, we love you. From our family to yours, we love you guys. And we're always here.
We love you, Alma.
We love you, Alma.
We love you. We miss
beautiful,
you.
Miss your beautiful smile.
We miss you, Thea.
We love you. We love you, Thea.
We
remember you. Always, always.
I'm so sorry for your loss. We'll miss our Thea.
Our sister. So Alex. And I love you.
For the family.
I love you all. And God bless you all. From the bottom of my heart.
Happy.
Okay, thank you, Brandon.
Thank you, everyone, for being here, making the time. I know everybody has busy lives and all, but thank you for dedicating some of this time today for Alma. We love her, we miss her, and she'll always be with us.
We love you, Mom.
I love you, Graham. You're always in my heart.
Hi, Mom. It's me. You know, me. I just want you to know that I miss you and I love you. And my best memory of you is, I have two, but the first one is when the janitor came over to your place and asked who Pops was, and he's sitting on the couch, and you said, "That's my brother," even though you guys are married. Because you had a crush on the janitor. It's a pretty funny memory. And my second memory is when you took Pops to the dentist. Oh, am I supposed to be looking here?
It's okay.
Sorry.
No worries.
I'm like looking at this. Is when you took Pops to the dentist and asked the dentist how much it would be to do a root canal. And he said $500, and you said, "Well, what if we just pulled all his teeth out? Wouldn't that be much cheaper?" And Pops is sitting there with the thing in his mouth, just almost crying in tears. But this is something that you would, you know, you would try to always save money and cut corners. So, but anyhow, I love you so much, and we miss you.
We